Manhattan Garment District, New York City, USA. Zerkheizi, a former associate of Morgenholt, may be working with someone known as Dvorak to gather classified intelligence about weaponized algorithms known as the Mars Kernels. Determine who Dvorak is and what his relationship is to Zerkheizi. Greetings, fellow earthlings. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. Now, we had raided the bank in Panama. Not exactly raided, but just, you know, browse through its inventory, so to speak. And what we found were just two names, Zerkheizi and Dvorak. Now, Zerkheizi was, like it says, one of the computational scientists working alongside Morgenholt, who sadly passed away under the pressure of torture. And he's somehow involved in all of this. Furthermore, there's also another person, another variable in the fray known as Dvorak, who we know nothing about. So, yeah, the plot thickens right now, and I do believe the next stop is Zerkheizi's home. Now, before I proceed, I just want to make a note of a few things. I actually disabled the HDR rendering because the shadows were not rendering properly, and I sort of bumped the brightness down because I want this game to feel like Splinter Cell. I want the shadows in place instead of, it looking like it looking more bright and sparkly. This game is best when there are heavy, heavy shadows, and I don't exactly want to spoil that effect. So, yeah, just that. Wanted to tell you guys about it, and I also installed the first person perspective, not first person perspective, the widescreen fix by 1380 because even though this game has native support for 1080p, it does have a few flaws. Some of the screen is cut off. I think it has got something to do with the FOV setting, but I sort of installed 1380's widescreen fix so that none of those issues occur, and you guys would probably be able to see it in the menu as well. I got to realize that yesterday when I was hacking, in the last level in bank when I was hacking some things, and I couldn't see the numbers on screen, so yeah.
So Zerkheizi and Morgenholt are the only two people who ever saw those algorithms.
And Morgenholt is dead. And Zerkheizi is connected to a mystery guest we know nothing about.
Dvorak.
Morgenholt and Zerkheizi are geeks, not terrorists. Maybe this Dvorak is some kind of puppeteer.
No hitter, bottom of the eighth.
2-0, New York in the eighth.
Akira Watanabe is on the mound. He's pure concentration, pure focus.
This is no coincidence. You're on your way to the Big Apple.
Bruce Morgenholt and Ibrahim Zerkheizi were partnered together on Project Watson, the UN committee that cracked the mass kernels. They're the ones who discovered 512 encryption, the same encryption used in the messages you recovered at MCAS Bank. If this so-called Dvorak person has somehow gotten his hands on mass-based IW algos, we're in a world of hurt.
I've been trying to penetrate Zerkheizi's private network since we connected him to this mess. I've seen some tough network security before, and I expected Zerkheizi to have top-of-the-line tech, but this is crazy. Zerkheizi's server isn't just impenetrable or invisible, it's like looking for a shadow in a pitch-black room. It's driving me crazy.
Sam would know all about that, wouldn't he?
Things are turning sour in New York. It's been 24 hours since the blackout, and no one has a clue when it might end. We've got sporadic reports of unrest all over Manhattan, but it hasn't started to spill over yet. Word coming down from above is that the National Guard will be deployed within the hour. We'll need to insert you into an alley behind a building adjacent to the target building. Watch out for civilians.
Yeah, so the starting of this level actually has armed guards, National Guard. They're considered civilians. I don't really know what their role is in the U.S. Security you know, scenario, but I'm guessing that they are mostly civilians who volunteer to keep the country safe. Anyhow, we will be taking the stealth loadout. There are no shots to be fired whatsoever in this mission anyhow. And let's begin then.
Fisher, the National Guard was deployed into Manhattan about an hour ago.
I feel safer already.
Watch your fire, Sam. Those boys aren't expecting to see you and they'll attack on sight. Do not, I repeat, do not kill any of them.
I'll be careful.
Good.
Right, so the only way forward is up this ladder here. If you try to go there, you will invariably be spotted. I'm just trying to be as quiet as possible, and I do believe that right now the night vision is making a difference. Because without it, things just look like this. You can't see anything at all. And I like it. I like it. Just as things should be in this game. Just take a look at this. Nothing. Just the light on Sam's back. That's all. That's all you can see. We just get to the side of this building and then we can proceed ahead by creating a distraction by essentially taking out an important light. And that's all that we need to do.
You have enough light down here?
Think so. These barricade lights are battery operated, so they should be okay. I have flares too if I need them.
Alright, then we'll concentrate on getting power to the CP before we break out to the perimeter.
Sounds good.
So you guys might notice that the dialogue back there is a little choppy, and that's partially my fault. I was not being careful enough. And we need to take this light out.
Stupid damn thing is broken.
There's also this guy that comes here, and we just want to, like, give him some space. We don't exactly want to bump into him or get spotted by his flashlight. So we're gonna just sneak by him, behind him, I mean. And then after that, we take out that light over there. Did I fail? I guess I did. I guess I must have failed. And now we're free to move along.
Fisher, looks like the National Guard are trying to restore the power to the building's elevator. That's probably your best way to the top.
I'll see if I can hitch a ride.
It'll be a long climb if you don't.
Huh, so the next section I do believe, as far as I've heard, is supposed to be a... Well, how do I put it? A reference to Metal Gear Solid, and we were just waiting for that guy to look away before we started climbing this ladder. It gives us free access all the way to the top. Since the electricity is out, we cannot exactly... Oh, what's going on? That's straight out of a horror movie. Is the elevator coming up? Oh no. Come on, we need to beat the elevator. Come on, Sam, no! Yeah, it's fine. You don't really need to do anything. It's gonna take care of itself. Don't worry about it. I was just being dramatic for the heck of it, to be honest. And this is guy here, we just need to be a little cautious when this guy is around. And that's it. That is pretty much it. So one of the issues with using the widescreen fix by 13EG is that the interactions get sort of messed up. Interacting with buttons on screen, buttons and elements on screen, I mean. They sort of get tossed all over the place. And I'm just gonna wait here until this guy gets back on his next patrol round. As close as I can get to the light, I mean. I am sort of partially in the shadows, and I would like to keep it that way. This guy is not really going to be an issue. Yeah, as soon as he... goes away, we are free to move upstairs. And there's also a helicopter that's making a lot of noise. There are some folks that came here. We can just jump over the pipes, really. And once we get to the center point, we can whip out a pistol and get rid of that light there.
The light should be on in
here. Oh, we can run a little here because there's a lot of ambient noise because of the, well, the helicopter there. We grab this quickly and...
Fisher, satellite shows you've reached the Casey's building. County Clerk's office has construction permits on file for the floors below the penthouse and in the neighboring structure.
Any plans or blueprints on file?
I'll have Grim look into it, with this blackout.
I understand. I'll see if I can dig up some plans down here.
Good idea.
So here's the thing. You should not be spotted here, but just in case, I'm gonna make a save right here. And the next section, you have to be a little careful in the next section because, well, I was just digging around with this game the first time around and I sort of tossed myself off the edge there. Well, almost
Fisher,
fell off as well.
That's a hired gun if I've ever seen one.
He's no night watchman either. He's a merc. He's got the same kit as the guys who were protecting Lacerda.
This whole situation is getting uglier by the second. See if you can find out who these characters work for.
Will do.
Right then, so... I guess we need to interrogate him by grabbing him and yeah, I'm just waiting for him to come my way so that I can actually do that. Now, here onwards is where things get challenging and this game starts getting fun. It's not to say that this game is not already fun, but it starts getting even more fun from this point onwards. Come on then.
What are you doing down here?
Who the hell?
Off to a bad start. Talk or die.
Okay. We're on VIP protection. This floor. We need to secure it because we can't lock it off from the penthouse.
Does the architect or engineer keep an office or a desk down here?
Yeah, of course. West side of the building.
Since you're doing so well, why don't you tell me the name of the PMC you work for?
I work for Displace. Displace International.
Displace? Wait, that's Shetland's company, isn't it? What's he doing in all of this mess?
If you're gonna kill me, do it quick!
Is he, like, supposed to be some sort of unwitting accomplice in all of this? Now, at this point, I need to consciously remind myself to use the right click.
Displace? That's Doug Shetland's company.
I know.
Fisher? If Shetland turns out to be crooked...
If Shetland is crooked, I'll take him down myself. But I have a feeling there's more to it than that.
Could be. See if you can find out who's in charge of this protection detail. Maybe someone inside Displace is playing both sides.
You got it.
Right then. So, you can hear his comrades calling out to him, asking him if he's alright. I don't think they are going to be an issue, but just in case. I'm just looking for any other paths of infiltration into this building. Seems to be only one. Can't really find any other path through. Can't really go there either. I only see like a hanging light bulb. Now, he did say that there's like a path that we can take to our right. Not to our right, to the...
It'll be done when it's done.
Done when it's done? What kind of answer is that?
Hey, I got a 220 connection here at 16 amps.
So?
So you know what that kind of juice will do to you if the wires get crossed?
No.
Well here, touch right here and find out.
No thanks.
Yeah, good thinking. Now get lost, it'll be done when it's done.
So, the thing that other guy was talking about, the architectural plans, on the west side of this building. That's pretty much our bonus objective in this level. The game doesn't really tell you about it, but the mercenary does, and if you chance into it, well, things are good for you. Well, the thing is, this guy is going to be able to correct this elevator soon. I'm just gonna be a fly on the wall until then. And that is the server room that we need to access, essentially. The guy's there sleeping over there, and we can just access whatever we need to from here. Where's his PC? Right here? Yeah, right here. Alright, let's do this. 191, 40... 191, 40, 68. Okay, this seems to be good.
Work permits, architectural plans. Interesting. Zerkheizi has a hardened panic room off of his bedroom.
I'll check it out.
Looks like he also filed plans for construction in the next building over.
The next building?
I'm no architect, but if I'm reading these plans right, both buildings are connected across a rooftop. I'll leave the relevant data on your opsec. Should help you navigate.
Thanks.
Yeah, so that is the appropriate way to do this. There is like a shortcut wherein you can cut one of those hanging pieces of plastic open, but it sort of leaves a mark of intrusion, so you don't really want to take that. So those are essentially that was essentially the bonus objective of this mission, and it essentially figures into the mission as well, because it tells you where to go. There is another way through it all.
Zerkheizi's cameras project an infrared beam, so they can see in the dark.
If it's an infrared beam, I can see it in my night vision.
Exactly. And listen, it would help us keep tabs on Zerkheizi if we could use these cameras against him.
Gotcha. I'll try and run some taps.
So, you can actually use your night vision goggles to check where the cameras are looking right now, these days. Like, in this level, what am I saying?
Good work, Fisher. That's one camera tapped. There should be five more.
I'll keep my eyes open.
Right then. From this point on, there are like a few things that you can do. This level is also quite emergent in how you can approach it. I typically used to approach it through... The elevator ultimately becomes free, and you can use that to approach this level. And you know what, let me just go ahead and take the path on the left instead. I think that would make better sense, because we have to come back this way anyway. So we might as well meet Zerkheizi first.
Looks like Zerkheizi has these doors maglocked on a remote switch. You'll need to find the computer that controls the magnetic lock.
Where would
right.
I find that?
It's probably in that panic room he keeps hidden behind his bedroom.
Right then, so basically we need to go that way anyway. Right. We don't need to be worried about this guy, he will not notice us. I wonder if I can just use the switch to take off. To like turn the light off in the shoe. Let's try. Whoops, wrong switch there.
Come on, get the lights back on.
Not what I wanted to do, but okay. I'll take what I can get.
Ah, so you're already Yeah, me and, you know, we go way back.
Stick with us. We know how to get things done.
I know. Like I say, we go.
There's a camera right there, and I'm trying to figure out how to tap it. So we basically need to go in there first. And this might take a few attempts. Let's hope that the guy does not see me. None of these guys do, as in. I see like this thing here, but I don't know where it comes from. There's like this open crate cover right here. But probably somewhere up there, maybe? Who knows? There's like an access, a way to access something here. Thought as much. So yeah, there's a crawl space right here. That's why there's a crate cover. So when you're playing Splinter Cell, unless you have to literally keep your night vision goggles on all the time, yeah, you're not really playing Splinter Cell properly. You should not be able to see anything without the night vision goggles, and that's just the way that the game is designed. Despite the beautiful, like I was saying, despite the beautiful atmospheres all around, it's sort of sad, but you have to essentially rely on the night vision if you want to see practically anything. And we're done tapping this camera. There's another camera over there that you need to tap. Pretty easy to get to it, actually. Nothing difficult at all. We just walk to it. Nobody's gonna be the wiser. Now, there is a guy there, and he's not gonna notice us. The only guy who can notice us is the guy that's patrolling over there. So I'm just gonna wait for him to finish a patrol before I make my move. And that theme music sounds very familiar. I think it's from Splinter Cell itself. At this Splinter Cell. That thing up there is also a... what do I call it? Event for us to get to the elevator, which is incidentally our extraction point.
Good work, Fisher. That's 4 of 6 cameras tapped.
I'll keep an eye out for the other two.
One of them is right upstairs. Again, not much of an issue at all. Going up these stairs, it might feel like some areas... there might be some areas where you feel like you might get noticed, but do not worry, that guy is essentially sleeping. Yeah, sort of messed it up once I got up there. So like I was saying, in this section, this part is pretty easy. The only part that you need to be concerned about is once you head upstairs, because right after you head upstairs, there's like a camera right in front of you, and the best way to deal with this camera is to essentially just take it out. Alright, now I can make a move towards it and tap it. So one of the things I've been noticing is that despite the fact that I can easily play my game without, you know, noticing too many shadows on screen, somehow my renders come out pretty dark. And I can't really figure out what's going wrong. The original recording isn't as dark, just the renders are though. I'm looking for the CPU for this. Let me see, does this camera get all the way there? Apparently it does not. Might as well make a run for it then. I guess we can't go all the way there. Must be just there for the heck of it. This, like, probably a light switch there or something. Let's try using this thing there. Oh. That might be what we... Interesting. Yeah, we can do only like force attack it, we can't exactly hack it. I do hope that I do not have to access that camera there, but... Oh well. Anyway, we need to enter this place here. There's nothing inside, do not worry about it. Right, and there's... I don't think there's anything in here either. Optic cable. I'm just gonna confirm once though. Isn't hard to be sure. And that's the computer which is going to enable you to get access to Zerkheizi's penthouse.
Gotcha.
Who?
Dvorak.
Where is he?
According to this, he's in the building next door. You can get there across the rooftop through the magnetically locked doors.
How do I get through the doors?
They're not magnetically locked anymore.
Thanks for the help.
This is a nice panic room, actually. It even has, like, toilet paper and stuff. Oh, I remember the COVID scare, when literally everybody was hoarding toilet papers. Yeah, so... being in the light should be that blinding. If it's not, then, like I said, you're not playing this game properly. Do not worry about being here, the camera will not spot you when you're here. It cannot physically do that. Neither will it spot you if you go on ahead, but let me just go and save you. There's a section up ahead where you can listen into some guys talking about some stuff. Actually, yeah, the final camera is actually in there, so let me just go ahead and do something here. How do I switch these off? Well, I guess I cannot, unless this is the switch. Yep, that was the switch. Alright. Let me try something here. Okay, trying it again. I'm just gonna turn these lights back on, and maybe I do not exactly need to...
How long have you known him?
...do anything else for the section here.
Long time. Since before this place. Since before Bosnia.
Before Bosnia? Good lord. I knew he had connections, but...
Yep. Know him a long time. He treats us good, we do what he says.
Yes. Yes, well, he sure treats us well.
Now you know too. Now you work for him. Do what he says.
Yes, well, certainly worth my while now, isn't it?
More than worth your while. He'll keep you alive, man.
I guess we just need to interrogate this guy or something. I don't recall exactly what we need to do, but something. It was something. So... if you're behind the door like this guy will not be able to see us. And we just grab him from behind. And ask him a few questions. We can dump his body in the corner here. I guess this guy will let us know who's in charge of the Zerkheizi protection detail.
I'm allergic to flowers. Maybe you should talk before I sneeze and accidentally cut your throat.
Oh, damn.
Oh, God! I'll tell you anything!
Good. Start with your boss. What's his name?
Nedich. Mylon Nedich. He's in charge of all our VIP protection contracts.
And how many of those under his protection has he killed in the last, say, 6 weeks?
What?
What kind of scam is he running?
I don't know about any scam. I swear! Don't hurt me! I'm not as tough as I act!
I can see that. Alright, time to knock him out and leave him right here. I'm trying to learn how to tune these guys, and thus far...
Mylon Nedich. Echelon's got nothing. He doesn't even exist.
Oh, whoever he is. He's playing both sides. We need to inform Shetland.
No can do, Sam. We can't compromise OPSEC for private interests.
Fine.
True.
If I find Nedich, it'll be less of a problem.
Admirable of you to protect your friend, but...
You said he doesn't exist. I'm just correcting a bureaucratic error.
Yeah, so I was sort of remembering that that guy needed to be interrogated for some reason or the other, and, well...
Good work on the cameras, Sam. We'll have guys watching Zerkheizi 24/7.
Always happy to keep the donut dippers busy.
Alright, down we go. Now, the thing is, we essentially... Going down the long way around is the far better approach than just, you know, trying to jump down the side. I wonder what's in the just a bath. Yeah, that guy is actually sleeping on his feet. He will not know where you are or who you are, no matter what you do. That, by the way, is the extraction. Now, the bad thing is that we need to get back here again. All the way here, after we are done with the warehouse, the penthouse, I mean. And getting off the side, it doesn't really work out for anybody. So I do believe this is the better route to take. Sort of has an element of backtracking to these levels, but hey, if it works, it works, I guess. That's all you can say. I love how Sam just reaches for his knife as soon as he's close to some bad guys. I believe I can jump over. Whoops, almost gave myself away there. Good thing I'm playing on normal and not realistic, otherwise that would have triggered a response from the guard. Alright, we can exit the front here, and then we can probably go in through there, actually. I don't know why I saved there twice, but... Now the problem is we need to take the slide out in order to progress. Oh well. Here it goes.
Who switched off the lights? Something's up here.
Something is up here, isn't it? Go check on the switch. Go check what it could be. Check it out. Go. The light is probably just malfunctioning. You're just getting off your rocker is all. Don't worry about it. It'll get better on its own. Yeah, you're a quick learner, aren't you? And there's nobody beyond this, so we're sort of clear to just access it as we want to. Oh, there's even like a grate here, I wonder why. Now we can open this door, but I sort of do not want to do it yet. Or maybe I do. Who knows, I can't really see beyond this door, so might as well open it. And I think we should be in the shadows as soon as we get out. As long as we stick to the shadows, we should be fine. And that, I do believe, is one of the ways that we can access that area. And this should be the other. Now, you need to be careful because there are folks up there looking into the area. We don't really need to do anything to the generators, we just need to get up there is all. So better keep that in mind when we make our maneuvers. Do I dare try right now? Now what's important to know is that this is a wall mine and you need to move very slowly in front of it. People who have not played the first few games do not know how to avoid this obstacle, they sort of just blow themselves up. You can only disarm it when it's green, like this. because if you try to disarm it at literally any other point in time, it's going to blow up in your face. And if you move faster than the slower speed, it is again going to blow up right in your face. And I can sort of imagine how immersive it all must be when you're playing it on like a console with a what do you call those things? Stick controls. Because man, you really need to be precise when doing that. It should make you like really sweaty. I feel like one wrong move and boom, you're blown up. We need to head down there. We can move a little faster now. That is the way we need to go, unfortunately. There's another landmine here, a wall mine here. Not that it's of any importance, it's not going to do anything to us, to be honest. All that area is just excess. Where we actually want to go is right up ahead. What I wonder at times is whether there is any other way to approach this section. Maybe from behind, somehow. If there is like a room over there. Now this wall mine, it is not going to interfere with us, so I'm just going to let it be here. I hope. There's like a toilet here with a medkit in case you need it. And it's just a little kitchenette, to be honest. There's nothing else here. There's like a gas grenade. And apparently a frag grenade, for whatever reason. I do believe we need to knock that guy out as well. But I haven't really figured out a solution to dealing with that guy, to be honest. So as long as you're moving at the slower speed, you're clear of any and all landmines. But short of that, well, you're in trouble. I forgot how to get behind that guy. I sort of figured out a way to come here where you can sort of get behind that guy. But I forgot how to do that. So let me just go ahead and try to use a stick camera to sort of distract this guy and try and get a move on. Excuse me there. Alright. Yeah, we made it.
What's up?
And I just wanna quickly crawl up behind him. Hack through this thing here.
Nothing here but ghosts and shadows.
Absolutely, you got that right. I'm sort of glad that I was successful in doing that, but I need to now hack this thing. Okay, that's how you lock in a few numbers. This could be 192, okay. Just one number, fine. And that's cool. I never really knew that you could do it that way. And seems to be that chamber there. I know I scum save a lot, like save scum a lot, but I do believe that is the only valid way to be playing this game. Oh wait, that's Zerkheizi over there. That's nice. So yeah, that's Ibrahim Zerkheizi. We can just talk to him. He won't really say anything to us. He doesn't really care. Splinter Cell Pandora tomorrow on the TV. Look at you, Zerkheizi. You're a man of culture.
You must be Dvorak.
Well, Dvorak, huh? I had thought this area was, well, off limits.
You're not Dvorak.
Well, since we're being blunt, well, no.
Then who are you?
Such a rush you're in. Fancy some tea, do you?
Lambert, something weird is happening.
I'll say.
What do I do?
The old man seems harmless. Indulge him. See if he knows anything.
Yeah, the camera angles in this game are a little...
Reminds me of poor old Jiggers. Oh, Jiggers. We hardly knew ye.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
Oh, well, one might ask you the same.
I'm looking for a man named Dvorak.
Ah, Dvorak, yes. Well, you're not going to find one. This way.
Okay, Mr. Casey, I will humor you.
Yes, here we are then. This is Dvorak.
Jesus. I think I just figured out why you couldn't hack in here, Grim.
Yeah, no kidding.
What the hell do I do now?
Hold on while I find a slide rule.
See what the old man knows, Fisher.
Okay. If this is Dvorak, who are you?
I am Dvorak's keeper. Thank you most kindly for asking.
And what is this Dvorak?
Dvorak is, well, you likely wouldn't understand.
I'm sure you're right. But let's have it for the record anyway.
Dvorak is a mechanical representation of a self-referential axiom of number theory. Dvorak encodes its own logical structure within its own executable cycle and recursively derives a more accurate representation of itself with each successive execution.
Right. Grim, did you get that?
My God, it's an infinite state machine.
Fine. What do I do?
If Zerkheizi is using this...
Grim.
Sorry, Sam, we're gonna need a copy of Dvorak's output so we can work out the algorithm it's built on.
How do I get its output?
It runs on punch cards.
Punch cards?
You'll need to restart the sequence and initialize each tower in the right order, and then retrieve the output stack.
How do I know the right sequence?
You'll need to hit the switches in order as the tubes start to heat up. Ask the old man for help.
Okay, so I guess we'll go back and talk to him. So, as a side note, Seishi Grim goes, wow, that's an infinite state machine. Then, the truth is that infinite state machines have been around for a long time. They came around during the Second World War. Alan Turing was the guy who actually made one of those things, an infinite state machine, that is. I do believe there was another way through the top to get here. We'll use that way to get back. I think it was a vent, probably deeper in one of the other rooms.
I need your help.
Indeed. What can I help you with, my good fellow?
I need you to help me initialize Dvorak so I can retrieve an output stack.
Ah, Dvorak. Well, that is certainly something I can help with. Why don't you restart it? I'll initialize the towers on this side, and you can do the other side.
Right then. So, where's the main server again? Oh, I think that's that's the first one. Only this one remains, I guess. This one? No, that's out of commission, I guess. Any other? Any others left?
Aha! There you go! Mm-hmm. Your output stack should be ready.
Mm-hmm. Is this the output stack? Oh, no. That is the output stack, right? Literal punch cards.
Alright, I got the stack.
Good work, Fisher. Time to make yourself scarce. Get to your primary extraction point.
On my way.
Okay, so let me just go and check out the goals, whether we have anything left. Just the extraction, nothing else, I believe. Primaries are obviously completed, otherwise they would not be suggesting extraction. Opportunity objectives, yeah, everything is done. Alright, up the stairs we go. I recall there being something upstairs. So I think there was like a vent or something which we could have used to come here. It should make the path much shorter for us. Not this room, but I think in the next room. So, I had always assumed that that guy was Zerkheizi, but apparently he was not. That guy was not Zerkheizi. So, makes me wonder, who is Zerkheizi then? Now, we need to make it all the way back to, well, the penthouse for extraction. A lot of back and forth in this level. A lot of back and forth. Let's hope we don't get blown up here. I mean, we don't really need to disable it, we can just ignore it and move on. Ah, there you are. Wait, is there a helicopter there? Why is there a helicopter there? We can move a little faster. Are you just gonna stand there? Sir? I guess you are. What if I take the computer out? Will that help you move, perhaps?
Typical! What's wrong now?
Good, thank you. Very kind of you to move, sir. No. Bad timing.
No one here. No signs of disturbance.
Almost got caught there. But then again, I suppose that is why people like playing these games. Alright, we close this door. Whoops, wrong key there. Yeah. Get under that, and what happened to the camera? Ah, there it is. As long as we make it to this corner, there's nothing to be afraid of. We enter the crawl space and come out the other side. I just wish we didn't have to backtrack as much. I mean, there is like an alternate way through it all. We just don't use it as much as all.
What the?
What happened? Yeah, and once you're in here, you can just climb up into the crawl space and head for extraction. Just a red box becoming larger as you get close to it, and this will lead you directly into the elevator shaft. And that's extraction for us. Right then. Huh. Okay, but I wonder why the opportunity objective is just like totally offset to the right like that. I'm guessing it's a bug from the widescreen fix mod. Anyhow, so basically we went to Zerkheizi's penthouse, and Zerkheizi was not there, leading us to wonder what might have happened to the poor soul. And we instead found a senile scientist who is working on what we now know Dvorak to be, an infinite state machine. So we essentially just put some tabs in Zerkheizi's penthouse to figure out what's going on, and we figured out who the mercenaries work for. Turns out it's Mylon Nedic, somebody inside of Displace, inside of Shetland's company of all people. And we also got an output stack from Dvorak so that we can better counteract any of the further information warfare attacks that, well, these guys might try, whoever they are. So the next lead that we have takes us to Displace, and it's sort of a very personal thing for Sam, because Shetland has been Sam's friend for a very long time now, and he has served with him on multiple instances. And we knocked out two guys. I probably should have just interrogated the second guy and left the first guy be. And that's sort of an oversight on my part, but oh well. Can't expect everything to be smooth always, like smooth sailing is butter. Now, This was it for Mission Penthouse. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be tracing the issue all the way back to its root. Or at least attempting to. And we will head to Displace International to try and figure out who this Zerkheizi... sorry, not Zerkheizi. This Milan Nedic is. So, yeah. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.